Hey you guys, welcome back to another Kimball's Corner. I just ordered the Vintage Pastels watercolor set from Prima Marketing Inc. I have no idea how they're gonna act. I have done absolutely nothing with them. So I'm going to take this moment to unwrap them and swatch them. So you better just swatch out. All right, we are down to dusky mauve, or mauve, however you like to say it. These are really, really beautiful colors. And they are numbered on the side, which matches the number there. They don't have dusky mauve written on the actual side, but it has 120, so you know, you can keep things in order. Ooh, so I'm going to activate them, just spritz them with some water. I'm gonna let them just kind of chill for a bit while I come up with something to draw. And I am using Strathmore watercolor paper, 12 sheets. It's a little thing, the 400 series. What other things can I tell you that's on this that you're probably reading? I don't know, cold press, that's exciting. It's 5.5 inches by 8.5 inches, 140 pound. There it is, that's what I'm using. Okay, terribly sorry about that. I was being called by a scammer and I just had to hang up on them and block their number. Anyway, I have the pastel pan from them, so I wanted to get the vintage pastels because these are gorgeous. And I'm gonna do a face, obviously, because why wouldn't I? Hello. Just something simple. So let's draw. And let's do a profile because I need the practice. Some kind of like, I don't know, design, maybe feathers, maybe just a colory explosion coming from her eye because I do what I want. And her hair, I don't, maybe I will. I mean, it's just gonna be that going right off the page. I could have it come down. Oh, okay, now I'm getting carried away. Do something simple like that. Just a little something more going on. All right, take this, my kneaded eraser. Just gonna roll it around just to get off some of the excess lead and get it ready to lay down some of these colors. They're gonna go on light and pale and beautiful, and I'm going to grab my Jane Davenport Texture Mermaid brush. I've had this paintbrush for a very long time. I've abused it a little bit, but we love it. We're good friends. Also, I'm gonna get some paper towel. Oh. Ugh, my water is full of sparkles. Be right back. All right, I'm back. The water has been deglittered. Let's swatch these out real quick. I am not disappointed. These are beautiful, beautiful colors. I mean, let's get in there. Are those not beautiful colors? Are those not beautiful colors? I think those are beautiful colors. Gosh, terracotta looks like such a nice middle of the road skin tone. It has also been a very long time since I've done anything, like any watercoloring on actual watercolor paper. Why? I don't know. Maybe I'll do the whole thing. Let's just wet the whole thing. Let's see what's gonna happen. Let's do terracotta over the whole thing. Just a light little wash. Let's add in this dusky mauve is really pretty. I'm putting in some pinks. Could add some pinks to her cheek already. This golden color. I mean, okay, maybe I should stop adding all of the colors at once. We'll stick with this dusty mauve. which would be actually a beautiful shading color. Let's lay down some more of this terracotta on the skin. Let's give this a quick dry. Be right back. All right, so it's probably not totally dry, but I do want I want to get started. I think I'm just gonna really, really play with colors. I'm not sure why, but I'm just wanting colors. Love these. A little scared to be like adding the blacks and stuff into them, but I will save that for, excuse me, Golden Glow. I'll be saving the blacks and stuff for a different project. So I'm gonna put these aside for now. Gorgeous, love them. Love the simple black travel case. And I'm gonna give this a good dry and pull out my colored pencils. So I'll see you guys in just a hot second. Literally a hot sec. All right, probably good, right? Right. So I'm just gonna use a black colored pencil. Et voila, sharp enough. I'm gonna go in and we're gonna take this messy look and refine it a bit, just cause why not? And I thought it'd be fun to just go in with the black pencil and really make the line work stand out. A relaxed, chill kind of day. Just a little bit of purple, I'm gonna see. Yeah, that does look a little bit better. I should have done purple. Why didn't you stop me? Take a Bitto blue. And just shade that eyeball a bit of white. Clean it off. Lighten up that part, get a little highlight on the nose. Just little hints here and there to make people go, what the hell was he thinking? Maybe I'll try good old burnt ochre to kind of go over the black line on the profile of her face to see if it'll soften it a little bit. Yeah, not so much. But I do like that it kind of takes away the texture of the paper. I'm intentionally like not going just over the black area because it'll help with my line width, as well as you'll see the brown. So it doesn't look just like a black line. What do we got? Henna. Henna, banana, banana. And that is really nice for her lip color. Ooh, she fancy. Now let's take that brown again, the burnt ochre, and just go over this eyebrow. Why didn't I go over with purple? She got purple hair. That's all right. And then I'm gonna take yellow, because I love adding bits of yellow into my artwork. And she does have yellow on her already. Ooh, this yellow is pop pop, holy cow. So we'll keep the yellow to the front of her face, draw the attention right there. And I said I was gonna do something with that. And I just don't know what it's gonna be, because that crazy. And I didn't think things through. You look pretty. What are you? That rhymed. True blue. There is no rhyme or reason to what I'm doing. I am having fun just adding color, as I always do. Let's bring the yellow into this side. Help detract from so much attention on the other side. Oh, that's nice. I think it's nice. You might think it looks hideous, and I'm okay with that. You will never have to look at it again if you don't want to, but I hope you do want to. I mean, I think it's pretty. Oh, there's my Jane Davenport white pen is downstairs. Do I have one here? I do have one up here. I mean, it's not a Jane Davenport one, which is like her new white marker is so fabulous at covering stuff up. And I totally would have done this with like a silver or something, but every time I use like my silver and or gold pen, I don't know what brand they are, they do not want to work like at all. And I don't know why. And it's very sad and upsetting because they were like $5 a piece. Am I going overboard with the white? Absolutely. Ooh, I want to just one white streak in the hair. Come on. It wouldn't be a Kimball's Corner video if that didn't happen. I haven't used this beauty in a while. Golden Age, Jane Davenport with a sparkle. I don't know if I'm supposed to shake this. It's been so long since I've used it. I'm scared. I wanted to tone that white down, but I still want it to have little specks coming through on the leaves. And this is nice. It's a little sparkly pen. Oh, so gorgeous. A little sparkle to the eyelid. It has like this, here's a piece of paper. Like it has just like a touch of gold to it. Oh, so pretty. And then it dries waterproof and then you can layer it and it gets darker and darker. Gorgeous. I know, right? I didn't think of it, but I wish I had. Kind of looks like a child got crazy right there. I smeared colors everywhere, but I don't care. I had fun doing it. Well, you guys, this might be the end of another Kimball's Corner episode. I hope you enjoyed it. I know I did. I always do. Just slapping some colors down. It's always good times. Wait, let's do this. Let's peel up this and see how that looks. Ooh. It's always a little scary because it's like, is it gonna tear the paper? We don't know. But that was a nice peel. It's suddenly so much more professional looking with the white border. These are the ones that usually peel on me. Ooh, fancy. Alright, don't let me down, don't let me down. That was satisfying. Well, that was fun. I really had a good time playing with the vintage pastels from Prima Marketing. I thoroughly enjoy them. They are gorgeous. I love the light, subtle color that they provide. I like that I can layer them. I like that I had a good time with them. So thanks, you guys, and I will see you all next Friday. Bye.